Solving equations by factoring. Must equal 0. Before we factor, the equation must equal 0. In order for our product rule to work, we need to have a 0. So to make factoring easier, we're going to want our x squared term to be positive. So we want a positive number in front of our x squared. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at some examples where we actually have to force the equation to have something equals 0. So right here in example 1, we've got 5x squared equals 2x plus 16. So we've got stuff happening on both sides here. In order to get a 0 on one side, we want to move everything all to the same side. I've got a positive coefficient in front of my x squared here. So I think I'm going to want to move everything over to the left-hand side. So that means I want to cancel out everything that's on the right-hand side. Minus 2x minus 16. So on the left-hand side, I've got 5x squared minus 2x minus 16. And over on the right-hand side, everything cancels out to 0. That's what we're looking for. Everything has to cancel out to 0. So then we want to factor this expression. And we'll end up with 5x times x. And then I want something that multiplies to 16. Let's try 8 and 2. I'm going to want to have my bigger thing be negative. Let's see if this will work. So if I've got 5x times 2, I've got negative 10x. And 8 times x will give me positive 8x, and those two subtract to give me my negative 2x. So we're good there. Then let's go ahead and set each of our factors equal to 0. So I'll have 5x plus 8 equals 0, and x minus 2 equals 0. Okay, subtract 8 from both sides. 5x equals negative 8, divide by 5, and then I get x equals negative 8 fifths. Okay, and then right here I'm going to add 2 to both sides. Okay, so we're getting multiple answers again, and this is looking a lot like our other solutions. We just needed to have this extra step that before we could do factoring, we had to set everything equal to 0. So let's go ahead and check out example 2 so we can get more comfortable with this. So again, we've got stuff happening on both sides. We want to move everything over to one side so that we've got a 0. We want to be careful here because this time we've got a negative 2x squared. So I know that I want to make this positive, so I think what I'm going to want to do is go plus 2x squared plus 2x squared. So then I'll cancel out the negative, and I'll end up with a positive 2x squared on this side. Okay, so now I have something equals 0, so I can go ahead and factor the right-hand side. So I'm going to want to have my 2x and x, something that will multiply to this negative 3, so I'll have positive 3 and a negative 1. So check, that'll give me minus 2x plus 3x, and when I add those two together I get an x in the middle. Perfect. So now let's go ahead and set each of these factors equal to 0. So 0 equals the first one, 2x plus 3, and 0 equals the second one, x minus 1. So, minus 3, minus 3, negative 3 equals 2x, divide by 2, divide by 2, x equals negative 3 halves. Here, it's a little bit simpler, just add 1 to both sides, and then I get 1 equals x. Okay. So this is the same thing as x equals 1. Doesn't matter which side of the equal sign we're on. And these are going to be our two solutions. So remember that you need to get a zero on one side of your equation before you can use factoring in order to solve for x.